Should we power through to our next topic here?
Yeah, you know what? Let's get a little help from Riley on this next one. Yesterday, we ended up talking with Micah Gusnak because the poor guy was up all night long. He had, you know, it's the worst when your alarm clock goes, when you wake up, like, you know, a couple minutes before your alarm clock, which is what happened two nights ago with Mike, with the thunder and the lightning, and to you too, probably.
Yep. I mean, the lightning was intense, and that was the number one thing people were reaching out to me on social media about, was just the prolonged period of nonstop lightning, and we had so much cloud cover that the lightning was really reflecting all over the place, so it felt like a strobe light, like we were at a dance party or something.
It really was. I had the day off, or, you know, the weekend off. I kind of did more of a staycation with the kids. And when it all started, I was like, okay. And I kept, you know, I looked at the radar and I was like, well, you know, they're getting going and stuff like that, and kept looking at some of the models. But, you know, a lot of times when I'm off work, I kind of just cash out and, you know, just go ahead. But it really was. It was like a disco. It was like a dance party almost. And I was wondering if my kids were actually going to wake up from this because the thunder was really loud. The lightning was just incredible. And I haven't really been through one of those storms like that. It's been a while. I mean, I've been through them before, but definitely have. You know, kind of an eye-opening experience with that one. My dogs, on the other hand, they were not happy at all. They were, you know, very nervous.
No.
but overall, the kids kind of just slept through it. And I was like, well, fingers crossed that they'll stay that way, I guess. But
you looked at this last night, Heather, for a good question, kind of analyzing what happens here. What did you find?
Because it's just like Riley said, it's just so strange, and it was so cool, but it was very strange. And Riley, you can help me with the weather stuff, because Mike kind of walked us through it. But really, to have lightning, you need ice up in those clouds. Those clouds are way high up there, and what's happening is sort of the ice is all rubbing up against each other and setting off this static electricity and this charge.
Right.
And the way Mike described it was there was just a lot of ice up there, and the storm was big and slow.
Right, yeah, we had really humid conditions. If you realize what it was like the night before, it was hot, humid, colder air aloft, so you get these ice crystals that will form. And it also has to do with the updraft, too. That's why the storms were so tall. You know, you get the updrafts going in, and that's also helpful with the hail, too. You get the updraft and the downdraft part of the storm. But when you have more ice, you know, you get that rubbing together, and you can get a lot of electricity from that. And that's what we were seeing the result of, was the lightning. And I think it was estimated that we had, you know, almost 5,000 lightning strikes. It was incredible. I mean, it was like, you know, per second or 1 to 2 seconds. I mean, we're talking about hundreds of it. It was crazy with it. In addition to the heavy rainfall that we had, some wind, of course, the gusty winds, but the hail. I mean, we had hail. I was looking out my window. And I think we got to about a quarter size and mainly pea, but I know off toward the west had anywhere from golf ball size hail, ping pong, to even larger. And when you get that large, you know, you definitely in a little bit of trouble with, you know, if you have cars sitting outside. Because I was sitting there and I was watching the radar, the reflectivity, and you could see little hail cores coming in. And I was kind of like, okay, do I need to move the car somewhere safer? That sort of thing, because it's on the street right now. Right. My garage is packed with some stuff that, you know, like my furniture and things like that. And makes me realize that maybe I need to clear that out and have that for the safe space for the car. But it was just really interesting to see how these storms really just blew up and the lightning strikes from it, for sure.
Well, good.
Right. And what's interesting, what Mike was saying, is that you couldn't have predicted it, because we don't know exactly how lightning works. We have a kind of an idea, but we don't know exactly. So it ended up being sort of a bit of a surprise, and it was cool.
That is interesting. Of all the things that you guys can forecast, we never hear a forecast for, like, this is going to be particularly lightning-y.
Right. Yeah.
Which is interesting.
Yeah, it was kind of a surprise for sure.
It was good.